Hello, good morning, everyone. Have your breakfast? Good. So let's move to the next phylum in animal kingdom, that is Coelenterata. Hi, Kirtana KH, Rakshita BM, Nirashri, Inara, Mohit, Krupa, Nitish, Srishti, Kalesh, good. Good. So randomly, I have just said hi to some people. So the topic, let me discuss directly. That is phylum Coelenterata. Phylum Coelenterata. Phylum Coelenterata is also called Cnidaria. I will tell you why the two names have been given. Coelenterata means coelom, means cavity. Entero means intestine. Ata means having. Animals, though, have a cavity inside the intestine. That is not body cavity, intestinal cavity. So that those animals are called Coelenterata. But modern science classified this phylum as name with a Cnidaria. Means they have a special cells for protection, defense, offense, and adherence for the attachment of the body to rocks, for escaping from the prey, and also from fight to the opponent. So these cells are called nidoblasts. Nidoblasts. These nidoblasts are look like this. Inside, a spring-like, thread-like structure will be there. This is one of the cell actually. When prey or any other organism touch this body, this thread will come out and sting with the organism. Then poison present in this sting will go and harm to the prey. That is how these cells are specialized in the Coelenterata organisms only. That's why these cells are called, according to these cells, the phylum is also named as Cnidaria. This is called nidoblast. Nidoblast is also called stinging cell. Nidoblast is also called stinging cell. Stinging cell is helps in defense, offense, and also adherence. These cells are present only in Coelenterata. Exclusive point this is. That is why another name of Coelenterata is Cnidaria. Clear? Coelenterata is the name which is old. Cnidaria is the new name. Understand? Good. Now, let us see the general characters of this phylum. Firstly, the very first one is habit. Habit. Already told in the last class. For the newcomers, I will explain again. Habit means how organism is living. How? This organism is free, or is this organism is a standard sessile, means a stick with somebody, some part which is not moving. Or organism is living single, solo, or organism is living group, colonial. These are comes under this point. So Coelenterates are free living. Free living, either solitary or colonial. Colonial means what? Colony means what? Group. Solitary means what? Single. So they are living freely. Some are groups, some are single. But if you see Hydra, which is sessile, Hydra is only sessile. So sessile means what? Suppose if this is the rock, Hydra is attached to this rock. Hydra is attached to this rock. Hydra, even though have a tentacles, the tentacles are upper side, which used to grab the food materials. So Hydra is sessile, means Hydra is attached to something which is not freely moving. Okay, mostly. Next, second point, habitat. habitat. Habitat means what? Where they are living. Where they are living. First, we have discussed how they are living. They are living freely within singles and also groups. And some organisms like Hydra are sessile. Now we are discussing habitat, means where they are living. Answer is they are aquatic. They are aquatic organisms. Aquatic in the sense they live in water. They live in water. But they may live in fresh water. They may live in marine water. Okay. So let us give the examples for this. If all are marine water, no need to give example. If all are fresh water, no need to give example. All organisms comes under the example. But few are fresh water and few are marine water means we must notice some examples. For the marine water, example, jellyfish. Okay. As well as Adamsia, sea anemone is a common name. These are the examples. Freshwater, example, Hydra. Hydra is a freshwater. Understand? So these are the two points. Please, guys, take a screenshot on this. Why? Because in my device, there will be some technical issue so that notes is not uploading. But video is uploading. After this session, soon I will upload this video in your group. But notes, I cannot upload. So that please take a screenshot. So this is the first page. Got it? Now, second page. Third point is level of organization. So before phylum, that is sponges. Sponges level of organization is cellular. Okay, only cells are there. But whereas in the Coelenterata, group of cells are present. All these group of cells are meant for single function. This is absent in sponges. That's why division of labor we said. But group of cells means what? Tissue. So that level of organization in Coelenterate is tissue, or cnidaria is tissue level of organization. Next, fourth point. Coelom. What is coelom? Coelom is absent, means acoelom. But cavity is present inside the gut, so that gastrovascular cavity. Cavity is different, coelom is different. Cavity means empty space, coelom means body cavity. Gastrovascular cavity is present, whereas in sponges, that is also acoelom. Paragastric cavity is present around the stomach, but this is inside the stomach. This short form is gastrovascular cavity, GVC. This is the fourth point. Fifth point, germinal layers. Germinal layers are two, so that we can call this is diploblastic organisms. They are diploblastic organisms, which means outer ectoderm is present and inner endoderm is present. This is endoderm and this is ectoderm. Mesoderm is absent, but between ectoderm and endoderm, there will be a mesenchyme is present. Mesenchyme is cellular. This is mesenchyme. Mesenchyme is cellular. Whereas in the sponges, between ectoderm and endoderm, mesoglia is present. Mesoglia is non-cellular. Mesenchyme is cellular. Very important. Okay? In that, cells are present. So this is about germinal layers. Till we have discussed 5 points. First one is habit. Second one is habitat. Third one is level of organization. Fourth one is coelom. Fifth one is germinal layers. Can you please take the screenshot for this? Okay. Next. Sixth point. symmetry. Symmetry means how this body, how these organisms body is divided. Radial symmetry. Radial symmetry. Suppose if you take Hydra. Hydra have a tentacles. How this body can be divided? Let us see. This body can be divided in this manner, two equal halves, and also in this manner, two equal halves. In the two planes. So we can say this is biradial symmetry. Biradial symmetry. With the two planes through central axis, body is giving two equal halves. It's called biradial symmetry. Some organisms are there. Those organisms are very spherical. These organisms can be divided in many planes. Two equal halves can be given. This is radial symmetry. This is radial symmetry. So possible symmetries in Coelenterata or Cnidaria is, first one is radial symmetry. Second one is bilateral symmetry. Understand? No. Let us move to the next point. Next. Body plan. Body plan. So, where, what is the body plan? How body is arranged? In case of porifera, body cells are loosely aggregated. That is the body plan. But here, body plan is blind sac. Body plan is blind sac. Blind sac means what? If organism is there like this, if organism is this, and does organism have mouth? Mouth is present, but anus is absent. Anus is absent. So that elementary canal is incomplete. Elementary canal is incomplete. Elementary canal is incomplete. Understand? That is why body plan is blind sac. I repeat this. Body plan in Coelenterata is blind sac. Blind means what? Incomplete. Okay? So that mouth is present, anus was absent. That is the reason it is called blind sac. If mouth is present, anus is also present, then what happens? Both together connected. That is called complete digestive system. Then that is not blind sac. Okay? So here, this is blind sac. Please, can you take the screenshot about the sixth and seventh points? Now, eighth point I'm going to teach. Right. Eighth point is nutrition. Eighth point is nutrition. Nutrition. How it will grab the food? Nutrition by tentacles. By tentacles. See, suppose if you take the organism like a jellyfish. Jellyfish is like this. So where the tentacles are downwards. This is the jellyfish body where its tentacles are being like this. So these are the tentacles of the jellyfish. Okay. And this is an umbrella shape. By these tentacles, it grabs the food. Tentacles helps in the collecting the food. Collecting the food. Suppose if you take a guys, please raise your hands. Let me understand that you are listening. Okay, good. So now, the next point, that is nutrition, that right? seventh point, that is nutrition. Right. So nutrition is holozoic nutrition. Holozoic nutrition means they collect entire the food in solid manner. Holozoic nutrition means collecting the food by solid manner, in solid forms of food has been collected, helped by tentacles. This is holozoic nutrition. In animals, maximum nutrition is holozoic nutrition. Understand? Next. Next point, body form. Body form. Body plan is different. Body form is different. Body form means here there are two forms are present. One is umbrella form. One is cylindrical form. Umbrella form means like this. Means tentacles are present downwards. Cylindrical form means tentacles are there upwards. This is example Hydra. Cylindrical form example Hydra. Umbrella form example jellyfish. Jellyfish scientific name I'll write here Aurelia. Another jellyfish is also there, that is Rhizostoma. Today you learned two scientific names of jellyfishes. One is Rhizostoma, second one is Aurelia. Jellyfish's special character, do you know? They show bioluminescence, means they emitting light from the body so that illumination takes place. Bioluminescence in Coelenterata only by jellyfishes, not all coelenterates. Okay. So when this umbrella form is there, this umbrella form named as medusa. Medusa, M-E-D-U-S-A. Medusa is the name given to the organisms in the Coelenterata, though have umbrella form. Umbrella form means tentacles are there downwards. See, jellyfishes is moving like this. So that is umbrella form. Whereas organisms, though have a cylindrical form, their name is called polyp. Their name is polyp. Let us see more characters and differentiations between polyp and medusa. Polyp, medusa, both. Let us see the differences. Differences between polyp and medusa is a very important 2 or 3 marks question in case of PUC. Polyp is a first difference. Polyp is a cylindrical form. Cylindrical form. You just observe. This is polyp form. And the first another difference is contrast. Medusa is umbrella form. Umbrella form. Umbrella form means dome shape. And tentacles are present downside. Like this. Okay, and polyp form cylindrical, but tentacles are present. Tentacles are upwards. Whereas here, tentacles are downwards. Where organism have a tentacles upward, that is cylindrical form. Where organism have tentacles downward, then that organism is called medusa. Okay, so if tentacles are upside, then they cannot move freely, so that If you see, this is a sessile form. So polyp forms are sessile. Sessile means what? Never move. Never move. Whereas, as they have a tentacles downwards, they move very freely. So that medusa forms are free living. Freely living. This is third difference. Fourth difference is, in the reproductive characters, polyp shows asexual form, asexual reproduction, whereas medusa shows sexual reproduction. Examples, I already mentioned, this is hydra, this is jellyfish. These are the differences between polyp and medusa. About this, I will tell you another important point. Organisms, though shows coelenterata, though shows only polyp in their life. In their life, only polyp. Only polyp means what? Always they are cylindrical. Okay? Only polyp. Example, hydra. Okay? Whereas, in coelenterata, organisms shows only medusa. Only medusa means what? Umbrella shape. Their tentacles are downwards. Example, jellyfishes, scientific name, Rhizostoma and Aurelia. See, in biology, technical terms are coming repeatedly. First time when we use the term, we feel difficult. Only technique is repeatedly using. Once we use that term repeatedly, it will be there in our permanent memory part of the brain. If you think that I don't know, it will be goes to your short-term memory part of your brain, then it will not be remained lost. You have to think that, yes, I learned this new term, Rhizostoma. Till now, I know only the name jellyfish. Today, I learned scientific name of jellyfish. There are two types of jellyfishes are there. Rhizostoma is also jellyfish. Aurelia is also jellyfish. Like that, you have to feel that you are learning something new, then it will go to your permanent memory. Whenever you recall, it come back. Understand? You don't think that I cannot. You don't think that I may not. You can. Every human brain is same power. There is no doubt. But compared to me, you have 10 times more creative mind, 10 times more greater thinking power. So that, see, I can say only biology, but you have to listen physics, chemistry, biology, maths. So here itself, I'm telling you are greater than me. So think always you are the best and move forward. Okay, let me continue the topics. So here, another important point, coelenterates who are always in polyp form, birth to death, they are in cylindrical form. They are called hydra. Example, birth to death, they are only shows one form, that is medusa form. Example, jellyfishes. Both are jellyfishes. Organisms, though show both forms, both polyp as well as medusa. Polyp changes into medusa. Medusa changes into polyp. That property is called metagenesis. Metagenesis. I'll explain you what is metagenesis now. Side heading, metagenesis. Alternation of generation. Alternation of generation between the polyp and medusa is known as metagenesis. I repeat, alternation of generation means this is polyp form and this is medusa form. Medusa is also in diploid. Polyp is also in diploid. Means set of chromosomes are same. Polyp converts into medusa, and medusa converts into polyp. But polyp converts into medusa by using asexual reproduction. Medusa converts into polyp by sexual reproduction. Actually, alternation of generation can be seen in plants. No animal shows this alternation of generation. From haploid to diploid, diploid to haploid, in plants, alternation of generation can be seen. But one and only animals, those shows alternation of generation between diploid to diploid. Diploid form converts into diploid. Again, diploid form converts into diploid. But this asexual reproduction performed by polyp, sexual reproduction is performed by medusa. By medusa. Understand? So, as this polyp and medusa forms are interchanging in one life, don't think that polyp is a complete life. Suppose if I am there, example, I can give you Obelia. Example is Obelia, who shows both the forms in the same life. Obelia. Another example, if you want, Physalia. These organisms, if I am Obelia, now I am sticking together to this chair, polyp form. From myself, one bud will come. Nothing but a small part will be separated. That is asexual reproduction. That's released part will become medusa. This medusa releases male and female gametes. Those two together fuse and form again sessile form. That will become a polyp. I repeat, polyp form is sessile. Medusa form is free living. Polyp form do asexual reproduction, form medusa. Medusa, inside the medusa, after some time, male and female gametes will be developed and fused together and forms polyp form again. So in the same life, like examples like Obelia and Physalia, in their life, polyp and medusa both can be seen. That character is called metagenesis. Understand? Whereas some coelenterates shows only polyp, some coelenterates shows only medusa, some coelenterates shows both. That is called metagenesis. Example, Obelia. Obelia is called C for common name, and Physalia. Physalia is called Portuguese man of war. Portuguese man of war means in Portuguese, army man get up is similar to this organism. That's why it is considered as Portuguese man of war. Understand? See how many we have discussed it? Habit, habitat, level of organization, coelom, symmetry, body plan, body form, all this has been discussed, and the nutrition. Now, digestion. Another point is digestion. Digestion is, digestive system is absent. Why? Because the tissue level, how system is present? So digestion and mouth is present. Anus was absent. So that this is called incomplete digestive system. Incomplete digestive system. And the mechanism of digestion. Mechanism of digestion is both intracellular and extracellular. But whereas in sponges, only intracellular. Why? Because enzyme secreting cells are absent in the sponges. That's why only intracellular. But in coelenterates, intracellular is possible. Extracellular is also possible. That is about digestion. Next, ninth point. Respiration. Respiration. Respiration is by body wall. Body wall. By diffusion. By diffusion. Next point. Circulation. I can say circulation is also same. Body wall by diffusion. Main method is diffusion. From high concentration to low concentration, materials can be passed out. 10 points has been discussed. Now, 11th point. Nutrition, digestion, respiration, circulation is completed. Now, excretion. Excretion is also by diffusion. Waste materials concentration is increased in the body. From high concentration to low concentration, they move through body wall. Now, after excretion, locomotion. Locomotion. Guys, are you taking the screenshots right? Good. Locomotion. Locomotion is by tentacles. By tentacles. Hydra is not moving, but sometimes it is showing the somersault movement, means flip movements. Now, 13th one. If you see the character of locomotion, all sponges are not locomoting, no movement. But in Coelenterata, few are not, but few are. So means character is developing. Few are moving. Next. Skeletal system. Skeletal system. What is the skeletal system in sponges? Calcium carbonate and silica spicules are present. That is why body is rigid like a rock. But in skeletal system here, if you see, some cnidarians act as a corals. Coral reefs, you know, some islands, coral reefs will be there, no? Because of their body is composed of calcium carbonate shells. Calcium carbonate shells. That is. Next character is nervous system. Nervous system. Whereas in the sponges, nervous system is absent. Completely absent, zero. No neurons. In sponges, I'm talking about the before phylum. But in the second phylum of the animal kingdom, Coelenterata, neurons are present. Neurons are unpolar. Unpolar means neuron is just like this. Whereas, you know, when I say neuron means, you can imagine the structure. You can imagine the structure just like this. Right? This is the neuron. This is called multipolar neuron. But whereas these multipolar neurons can be seen in the developed animals. Coelenterata is a very second developed animal, no? So that multipolar neuron is not present in that. Unpolar neuron, no poles are there, just round. Round, no poles, no axons. So that one neuron is connected with another neuron and forms diffusible nerve net. Diffusible nerve net. This is the story of nervous system. Nervous system, neurons are present. They are unpolar neurons. No poles are present. Next, 15th point. Sensory system. Sensory system. Sensory system, tentacles. And also, statocyst is present. Statocyst means, if you see, this is a jellyfish. Here, some statocysts are present on its dome shape. They guide the organism according to the water currents. Suppose water currents are coming like this, tides. Opposite, it cannot flow, it cannot swim. Why? Because energy will be waste. So if water flow is coming in this direction, organism is moving this direction because of the statocysts. Okay, that is about the sensory system. Now, 16th point. Reproduction. Reproduction. It shows both sexual and asexual. Asexual reproduction shows as well as sexual reproduction also shows. If we talk about the asexual reproduction methods are two. One is external budding. External budding. Suppose if you see the hydra, hydra shows buddings like this. Once this bud is separated, new hydra will come. So, whereas in the sponges, internal budding, gemmules. But here it is external budding, example, hydra. Another one is fragmentation. Fragmentation, when hydra cuts into pieces, new hydra will come from the every piece. So that is here also example, hydra. Hydra shows two different asexual reproductive methods. One is external budding, another one is fragmentation. Now, sexual reproduction, let us discuss in the next page. sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is done by gametogenesis. Gametogenesis means male produces sperms, female produces ovum, but male and females are not separate, so that organisms are bisexual. I explained already, means one organism consists of male as well as female. They are not separate. Sex, bisexual means what? Sexes are not separate. That's why this condition is also called hermaphrodites. Hermaphrodite. Herma, god. Aphrodite, goddess. God is male, goddess is female. Both are in same picture, so that hermaphrodite. It is also called monoecious. All these terms are same. Monoecious means single body consists of both male and female. Now,
it's 10 hours.
Fertilization is internal. Internal fertilization. Whereas development is indirect. Indirect means larva should be present. If direct development, eggs delay. Indirect development, larva stages will be present before the forming of adult. So that larva is present. There are two larvas, common larva. All organisms have this larva. This is called planula. Planula is a common larva, whereas jellyfish's larva is separate. Jellyfish larva is called Ephyra. Ephyra. E-P-H-Y-R-A. Ephyra. Okay. This is about sexual reproduction. Now, unique features of cnidarians means characters that you observe only in cnidarians. Number one, metagenesis, not all, only few. Number two, having needleblasts. Needleblasts are also called stinging cells. And third character, jellyfishes are included here. Jellyfishes shows bioluminescence, emitting light from by the living organism is called. All these characters are unique, only can see in cnidarians, not in any other organisms. Understand? Unique characters. Before we have seen that, all general characteristics. Okay. Now, what are the features we have discussed here? Habit. Check it out, your notes. Habit and habitat. Level of organization. Coelom. Symmetry. Body plan. Germinal layers, body form, nutrition, digestion, respiration, circulation, excretion, locomotion, nervous system, sensory system, skeletal system, reproduction, in that asexual and sexual. Asexual reproduction is external budding, Hydra example. Fragmentation, Hydra example. Sexual reproduction, organisms are monosexual or bisexual? Bisexual. Monoecious. Monosexual is different, monoecious is different. Also called hermaphrodites. Both male and female gametes are formed in same body. Fertilization is internal. Development is indirect. Larva is present. General common larva is called planula. Jellyfish's exclusive larva is present. That is called Ephyra. If you ask me, what is the difference between Ephyra and planula? Ephyra have a cilia, so that's swimming. Whereas planula do not have a cilia. okay, hair like structures are absent. Unique features of need area, metagenesis. Metagenesis means both polyp and medusa forms. Polyp becomes medusa, medusa becomes polyp. This is called metagenesis. Okay, if you want examples in this organism, cnidarians, examples, let us copy. First one, Hydra. Second one, Obelia. Obelia common name is Cepher. Third one, Physalia. Physalia, Portuguese man of war. Portuguese man of war. Fourth one, Velella. Fifth one, Adamsia. Adamsia, it is also called Metridium. Common name is sea anemone. Next, Gorgonia. Gorgonia, sea fan. Next, seventh one is Penentula. Sea pen. Common names and scientific names are important. Let me pronounce all the terms again so that you can feel easy. First one is Hydra. Second one is Obelia. Common name is Cepher. Third one is Physalia. Common name is Portuguese man of war. Fifth one is Velella. Sixth one is Adamsia, also called Metridium. Common name is sea anemone. Next, Gorgonia, G-O-R-G-O-E-N-A, Gorgonia, sea fan. Penentula, sea pen. So these are all the data about cnidaria or coelenterata. Now, another phylum, which is not so huge data, very easy one, that is Ctenophora. Why I am discussing two phylums in a day means, Ctenophora, some years ago, it is one of the part of Coelenterata only. But due to some exceptions, it is placed out. What are the exceptions if you see? First one, they are exclusively marine organisms. Marine organisms. They live in only marine. That is why they are separated from Coelenterata. In Coelenterata, organisms are fresh living as well as marine water living. But Ctenophora, all Ctenophora organisms are living in only oceans. Okay, this is exclusive point. Second exclusive point is absence of nidoblasts. Absence of nidoblasts. Nidoblast means what? Stinging cells. Stinging cells are absent. Stinging cells should be present to say that is Coelenterata or cnidaria. As they do not have, they are separated. Now, if nidoblasts are absent, then what is present? Presence of Ctenoblasts. Ctenoblasts. Ctenoblasts are also stinging cells. Structurally, they are different. Fourth character. All of them shows bioluminescence. Bioluminescence, emitting light by all the organisms in Ctenophora. Whereas in Coelenterata, only jellyfishes. Understand? Now, fifth point. Comb plates are present. Comb plates helps in locomotion. Locomotion. Okay, and tentacles are absent. Tentacles are generally absent. If present, only two. Organisms here, these organisms are look like gooseberries. That's why they're also called sea walnuts or gooseberries. Gooseberries, just like a volleyball, football like structures. Let me draw for your better understanding. This is the mouth. And this is the anus. organism is like this. Mouth and anus are present but are not connected. Intestine, middle, it will become left alone. So this is mouth, this is anus. Whereas in the coelenterata, mouth is present, anus was absent, blind sac. But here mouth is present, anus is also present but not connected. So this is also blind sac type. And organism consists of 8 rows of lines. Organism consists of 8 rows of lines. See, this is the number 1, is the number 2. Rows are not coming properly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Organisms have 8 rows. In each row, there are many small teeth-like structures. They are called comb plates. So the comb plates are many arranged in 8 rows, helps in locomotion. I repeat this point. These are called comb plates. Comb plates arranged in 8 rows. Okay, comb plates are arranged in 8 rows, helps in locomotion. These characters are absent in coelenterates. Next. So what are the, how many points we discussed? 7. Now 8th point. Only sexual reproduction. Only sexual reproduction. Whereas if you see in coelenterata, both sexual and asexual is possible. But in Ctenophora, only sexual reproduction. 9th point. Fertilization is external. Fertilization is external. Development is indirect. Development is indirect. Indirect means larva is present, right? Yes. Larva is present. Larva name is Cydippid larva. Larva name is Cydippid larva. All these are the characters of Ctenophora. I repeat Ctenophora again. Ctenophorans, once upon a time, they are grouped in coelenterata. Because of some 10 different characters, they are placed out of the coelenterata. What are the characters? Apart from all these 10 characters, remaining characters all are same. So that I did not give in the data like nutrition, digestion, respiration, circulation, all are similar to Ctenophora. And not written here means what? That is similar. In your notes, you make a sequence like under the Ctenophora, habit, habitat, level of organization, coelom, symmetry, body plan, body form, segmentation, germinal layers, nutrition, digestion, respiration, circulation, excretion, skeletal system, sensory system, nervous system, reproduction, all you just list out, right, one by one. Where it is differing, make them star mark. So, what are the characters where Ctenophora is differentiating with the coelenterata? I will repeat again. First point, that is, they are exclusively marine. They live in marine only. Second character, nidoblasts are absent. Stinging cells are absent. Instead of nidoblasts, Ctenoblasts are present. Fourth character, all organisms here shows bioluminescence. Whereas in the coelenterata only, jellyfishes. Next. Comb plates are present here. They are arranged in 8 rows, but comb plates is many in number. They help in what is the function of comb plates? Locomotion. Okay. And the tentacles are generally absent. If present, only 2. Example for this animal, Pleurobrachia. Pleurobrachia and Beroe. These are the examples. Another character. They shows only sexual reproduction. Fertilization is external. Whereas in the coelenterata, fertilization is both. Fertilization is only internal. But here fertilization is external. Means sperms comes out of the body. Ovums comes out of the body. fusion of gametes takes place outside. Here student may confuse, in Coelenterata fertilization is internal and Ctenophora fertilization is external. It means in Coelenterata animals are hermaphrodites, bisexual. In the Ctenophora organisms are monosexual. Wrong. Both are bisexual. In both sexes are not separate, but fertilization in Coelenterata takes place inside the body. In Ctenophora takes outside the body. Fusion of male and female gametes takes outside the body and telling. Development is indirect. Whenever you see indirect development, there will be a indication of presence of larva. Larva name is here centipede, whereas larva of Coelenterates is planula. Jellyfish's exclusive larva is Ephyra. Guys, now time is completed. 10:15. The topics today we have covered two phylums. One is Coelenterata, another one is Ctenophora. Understand? If you have any doubt, ask me personally. I hope you understand. No need of recap. Okay, I'll put this video in your respective groups. And please take all the slides screenshot from the first I will represent. If you are not, please take it. Take this screenshots, please. This fourth slide, fifth slide, sixth slide, seventh slide, eighth slide, ninth slide, 10 slides, 11th slide, 12th slide, 13th and the last slide. I will give you a tip for this class. First, read Coelenterata all the characters. Next, read Ctenophora all the characters. Later, go for similarities. What are the common points between Coelenterata and Ctenophora? Next, go for the different dissimilarities between Coelenterata and Ctenophora. Then go for examples. Then you will get it. All the best. Take care.